Hi, this is Rob. I will show you how to find the x and y intercepts of a function using the graphing feature of the TI-84 Plus CE calculator. We're going to use the polynomial equation of x squared minus x minus 6. First thing we need to do is graph this equation. If you need more help on how to use the graphing feature of the calculator, please see my video, How to Graph a Polynomial Function Equation on the TI-84 Plus CE. I'll put a link in the description below. Okay, let's get started. Press the Y equals key on the top left of the calculator, here. Enter X, located on this key. Then press this exponent key. It moves the cursor to the exponent position. Enter 2. To move the cursor out of the exponent position, press the right arrow key here. Then enter the rest of the equation. Minus x, minus 6. Now press the graph key located in the upper right here. You should get this graph. If you don't get this graph, you may need to reset your graphing window to the standard view. To reset your graphing window, press the zoom button here on top. Go down to number 6, Z standard, which stands for zoom standard. Press the enter key. Now you can do a visual and see that the graph crosses the x-axis at negative 2 and positive 3. Those would be our x-intercepts, but we want to get a confirmation from the calculator. So next step is to press the second key here, then the trace key here. This brings up this calculate window. Go to number 2, 0, press enter. You see the blinking cursor on the graph? On the bottom of the screen is asking for a left bound. We will confirm the x-intercept at x equals negative 2. So we want to set a left bound left of x equals negative 2. Using the left arrow key, move the cursor left of x equals negative 2. That is good. Anywhere to the left of x axis of negative 2. Press the enter key. Now the calculator is asking for a right bound. Move the cursor using the right arrow key to the right of x equals negative 2. Okay, right there is good. Press the enter key. Now the calculator is asking for a guess of the value of x-intercept within those bounds. Skip this step and just press the enter button. And at the bottom of the screen we see our answer. One of the x-intercepts is at x equals negative 2, y equals 0, or negative 2 comma 0. To find the other x-intercept we will repeat the steps. Press second, trace. Go to number 2, 0, press enter. On the bottom of the screen it says left bound. With the right arrow key, move the cursor to the left of where we think the other x-intercept is located, at x equals 3. Right there is OK. Press enter. Now the calculator is asking for the right bound. Move the right arrow key until the cursor is just to the right of x equals 3. Right there is good. Press enter. Now the calculator says guess. We skip that and press the enter key again. And there on the bottom of the screen it says x equals 3 and y equals 0. That is the other x-intercept. Now I'm going to show you an easy way to find the y-intercept. Press the second key, then the trace key. This calculate window appears. Select one value. Press enter. The intercept occurs when x equals 0, so on the bottom of the screen, type a 0 after x equals. Then press enter. And at the bottom of the screen, there is our y-intercept at y equals negative 6. Okay, that's it. That is how to find the x and y intercepts of a function using the graphing feature of the TI-84 Plus CE calculator. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and please subscribe to this channel.